Ready? One. You will do this four times with the left, four with the right, then eight times with both, then repeat. Body moving, body
moving. What's up, what are you doing? Look about the back, look up too. Cut the music before I get copyrighted again. It's the Brooklyn Bodgers back. That's Body Moving by the Beastie Boys. And if you don't know that song, then I don't know what to tell you. But we're back with another lecture. It is Monday, September 14th. If you're a student in my class right now, and let's just do this real quick. Let's get past this title slide, for Christ's sakes. Jesus. Class outline. Let's take a look at the homework due. Again, if you're a student of mine right now, this makes sense. If you're just somebody out there in the world watching my YouTube, don't worry about it. Because this is the main topic for today. Joints and movement, hence that little song, huh? Body moving. Let's get it going. All right, students of mine, feel free to pause the video right here. I'm not going to talk you through this whole thing, but pause it and study this. We're here right now, and we're moving forward. So pause it, and we'll be right back. Boom, and we're back. Stay organized. I'm not talking you through this whole thing. We've seen it so many times. It's on Instagram. You know what to do. What you got to do right now is take a deep breath and get ready to dance. Get ready to move your body. Get ready to study joints because we're body moving. We're doing joints and movement. Anybody remember this guy, that movie? Goofball, right? Let's keep going. Joints / articulations. Quite simply, where two or more bones meet. Okay, we're off to a nice slow start. Let's keep it going. They're useful for binding and mobility. Yeah, it's... Thank goodness we have joints because it allows us to do all sorts of movements. All right. Now, there are two ways that joints are typically classified, and we're going to knock them out one by one. The first way you can classify joints is by their function or by that level of mobility that they may or may not have. The second one is structural, and a lot more emphasis is put on this one. So let's do this. Let's do the functional breakdown first. That's coming up in just a moment. And then we spend a lot more time, trust me, we spend a lot more time on the structural. But you got to know both. So let's keep it going. All right, the functional classification. So we go over here. If you are a joint that does not move at all, we'll look at some examples in lab, and I might be able to mention some in some future slides, then you are synarthroses, or without articulation, essentially, synarthroses, not moving. Okay, that's the first one. The second degree of functionality is antiarthroses, or slightly movable. Okay, in fact, I should do some, let's back this up for a second, let's back up, because I don't know if the slide's gonna, can you think of an immovable joint in your body? Pause the video, and we're back. How about the joints holding together the bones of your skull? Oh, they are immovable. At least I hope they are. All right, same thing, same question. Pause the video. Can you think of a joint that is slightly movable in your body? And we're back. I like the pubic symphysis that links together your two coxal bones anteriorly, your hip bones. Ooh, all right. And finally, diarthroses, freely movable. There's that question mark. Boy, sometimes I ruin my own slides. Easy one, softball question, right? A big old fat softball just lobbed at you to smack out of the park. Can you name a fully movable joint in your body? Pick one, pick any of them, right? Okay, let's go. Now, the structural classification is a lot more complicated, okay? With additional vocab, so we're done with this. Ding, right? And now structural, and this is gonna become our map screen. You remember this. That means we're gonna have sort of an outline pop up here, and we're gonna check, 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 and we're gonna bang these things out, right? So let's look at the structural breakdown of joints in the body. There are three types of what are called fibrous joints. Okay, this is just a summary. There are two types of joints that we classify as cartilaginous, five syllables, cartilaginous. And then there are six joints, these are the ones that most people know about already, that are classified as synovial, four syllables. All right, well, let's go in order. Like I said, this is our map slide. So we will start with fibrous, finish them off, move on to cartilaginous, finish them off, and then finish up with synovial. All right, fibrous joints coming up. Ooh, The stopwatch is up, which means you should pause this video right now as a student and take this as an opportunity to just do some observation on your own. I'll be right back. And I'm back. All right, what did you notice? What do you see about fibrous joints? Maybe you jotted down some ideas. Maybe you jotted some things down in your head. Like, doesn't look like they move too much. Pretty interesting locations. Maybe you didn't think about the fact that you have joints and articulations, if you will, in your teeth or holding your teeth into the sockets. Maybe you never thought of it that way. Remember, I didn't. All right, so fibrous joints consist of dense fibrous connective tissue. And we know what that means. That's good, because we already covered tissues. No joint cavity. We will see that that's important later on when we get to synovial, okay? So there's no space, no lubricating reduction and friction space filled with synovial fluid. No cavity, okay? No joint cavity, right? I don't see any joint cavity here. Don't see any joint cavities here. Ditto with the teeth, okay? And they are mostly synarthrotic or immovable, okay? Now, each of these, that's a good overview, but each of these has a pretty complicated name that we're going to have to learn, and we're going to do them one by one in just a moment. Here they come. Three types. Number one, a suture. Whew, off to an easy start. That's not too bad. That's not so bad, right? These grow, you know, experience growth during youth, and when you're a baby, they're a little bit more sort of separate, and there's a little bit of flexibility there. We'll look at the fontanelles on an infant skull in the lab, okay? Feel free to read this summary up here. I don't want to do the whole thing for you. But short interconnecting dense fibers, okay? Found only in the skull. Found only in the skull, okay? And those short fibers initially allow for expansion, and later they ossify, all right? So have fun with infants and small babies and like, oh, your bony plates in your head are still soft and kind of movable, right? It's a classic question. Why would you want that function? Think about it, but we're going to move on. Next up in the fibrous joint category, syndesmosis. That's a four-syllable word, syndesmosis. Okay. A joint held together by a ligament? Sure. Fibrous tissue can vary in length? Sure. Longer than a suture? Longer than a suture. Okay, so here's a classic instance of where this happens. This is the tibia and this is the fibula. And they're held together distally by a syndesmosis joint. All right. Movement varies. Okay. Movement varies. You don't have a lot of movement at this joint here in particular. Okay. Okay. Because you want stability in that ankle. All right. That's suture. Check. Right. Syndesmosis. Check. Last one. Gomphosis. That's a three-syllable word. Gomphosis. All right. Peg in socket is what that means. A fibrous joint, peg in socket. And the periodontal ligament holds the tooth in the socket. This is the only example are in your teeth. Peg in socket, gomphosis, and the fibrous connection is the periodontal ligament. Very small, very short in length. Look at that. Okay. Excellent. Fibrous joints. So not a lot of movement, right? These are meant more for stability and really holding things together. Our next category, according to a map, is cartilaginous. And we have two types there, cartilaginous joints. Okay, let's move on. Ah, the stopwatch is up again. So take a moment, pause the video. I'm not joking, take that seriously. Pause the video right now, pause it. I'll come back in a bit. And I'm back. All right, so maybe you noticed, ooh, cartilaginous joints. This reminds me of the epiphyseal line when we were doing the skeletal system overview. Oh, this reminds me, this looks like the costal cartilage, right? When we did the thoracic cage. Oh, I see the ligaments that are holding together our vertebrae, and ooh, there's that pubic symphysis. Okay, let's take the stopwatch away. Let's get some information on this slide, shall we? Bam, once again, no joint cavity, no synovial cavity, no synovial fluid. All right, not very movable. Okay, so we're still not looking at the category of joint of articulation that is meant for body moving. That's okay though. let's name these two types. Let's name this one, and then we'll come back and name the one that you see down here. So these two share something in common, and these two share something in common. Here we go. The first one, synchondroses. Woof, that's four syllables, synchondroses. And they are classified as cartilaginous joints, and the type of cartilage they have is hyaline cartilage. Ooh, I'm so glad that we mastered all those tissues a couple of weeks ago. Two examples seen here. Yeah, epiphyseal plate. Sure. Sternum and rib attachment. Excellent. Okay. Let me back that up. Give people a chance to absorb that. Give you a chance to absorb that. Pause it if you'd like. Okay. Synchondrosis made up of hyaline cartilage. Two examples here. The next one is the syntheses, are the syntheses, I should say. And they are made up of fibrocartilage. You have a little bit of hyaline cartilage also present, but the main type of cartilage is that fibrocartilage. Mm. And we know fibrocartilage can be found in the intervertebral discs, check. And in that pubic symphysis, check. Okay, we also know that fibrocartilage is present in the knee menisci. These are strong and somewhat movable. Somewhat movable. You do have some movement in between the bones of vertebrae, and you do have some wiggle, if you will, here between the two coxal bones. Helps you to walk, actually. And here are the two classic examples of those cartilaginous joints, intervertebral discs, pubic symphysis. Bam! Well, my friends, in the interest of keeping these videos short and simple, I'm gonna end it there, and we're gonna pick this up with part two and do the largest of the structural categories, synovial joints. Ooh, there's a lot to say there. So let's recap. We talked about joints, and we knocked out the functional classification, and there's three types of those based on their mobility, like zero, some, and highly mobile. But then we've looked at two of the categories of structural. Part two of this video, we're gonna do synovial. We'll come right back to the screen, I promise. Let's do a little play out music. Brooklyn Biologist signing up for now. Part two is coming up real soon. Let's hear it. And you're done. Boom.